Olive Diemelo, the acting head of programs at Catholic Relief Services Uganda, which implemented the program together with Caritas under New York, says the program is being implemented in the four districts of Abim, Napak, Nabilatuk, and Nakapiripirit.
My name is Olive Diemelo. I'm currently the acting head of programming at CRS Uganda. Our main office is in Kampala. And we have been implementing the New York project, and New York in the Karamojong language means it is ours. And the New York project is a USAID funded project that we've implemented in four districts of Abim, Napak, Nakapiripirit, and Nabilatuk. The New York project seeks to improve and sustain food and nutrition security of 181,053 vulnerable people in Abim, in the four districts that I mentioned.
Fiburi, humanitarian assistance officer with USAID. Fortunately, we were here a few months ago, and we came when it was flooded, and it was almost impassable. It's rewarding to go ahead and see the condition that it's reached now. There were discussions that continued with the engineers at that time and really plotting how best to address the rising water levels, and it looks like you've achieved what was discussed, and congratulations. So again, the partnership with community, government, NGOs such as CRS and ourselves is just a good example of what we can do when we all work together. So for that, congratulations. And
thank you.
James Shilaku, the RDC of Abim District, appealed to partners to work on the remaining part of the road to aid movement to Otore, Soroti, and Katakui.
It has multiple importances. One, security. It is going to help us to be able to move our troops from Rakerotuke up to Awach, up to Agago, in the case of attacks by the cattle raiders. As you are aware, we have insecurity of cattle raiding, cattle rustlers, illegally armed warriors.
And I'm only getting some disturbing news that New York or Caritas is soon ending their contract. We can also come in with the RDC and our cow to put our hands somewhere so that they extend this program for some good years again.
The RDC asked the district engineer to ensure the road is well maintained. He also warned residents against dragging ox plow on the road, saying it causes damage. What they have done on this road is very good. Now that they have rehabilitated our road, those coming from Otore to our market can easily bring us food. In the past, whenever it would rain, the road would get flooded and people get accidents. We also used to travel long distances to seek health services, and many pregnant mothers would give birth on the road before reaching the hospital. Things have changed for the better. The road was very bad in the past. This rehabilitated road has made movement very easy. We are grateful.